peace, what up? My name is Vander Hill, aka Wacko, aka The Last Black Man at SF, and I'm about to tell you guys my story. So, I'm born and raised in San Francisco, California, raised in the Mission, Fillmore, been living in the Mission basically my whole life. For the last year and a half, I've been fighting eviction in my apartment. My roommate moved out. At that point, my landlord decided to raise the rent from $1,839 to $3,500 during a pandemic, which was not supposed to happen given the current state of emergency. I think I represent like what most natives go through, trying to stay in a city that we still love. Rising the chapter, yeah. Deja vu, tell you what I'm gonna do, when they reminisce over you, my God, my God. So,
yeah, so lovely. That's how we like to do it in the 90s. When I date back, I recall a man off the family tree, my right hand Papa Doc.
Schools I went to, Sacred Heart Elementary School from kindergarten to third grade. After that, I transferred to Mission Dolores. After Mission Dolores, I went to Reardon my freshman year. After Reardon, I went to Galileo from sophomore to senior year. After that, I was at City College for about 6 months. And after City College, went to the Art Institute. I got my bachelor's in graphic design. So I know when people think about San Francisco right now, all you really think about are the tents that you see on the sidewalk, and that's a sad reality. Again, being a local, what most people don't know is a combination. A lot of those folks that you see in tents, those are locals. They're victims of the system, not getting to them in time. Every night I go to sleep, I'm stressed out. I keep being told that I have time, I'm protected, but I don't believe that. My hope is that I don't end up on the streets in a tent. Somehow during all this too, I started my own business, Whack Donuts, which is a vegan-based, plant-based donut. With the rise in tech, you've seen a lot of things come and go. I know a lot of families and small businesses that have either shut down, moved on, even prior to the pandemic, but that's only increased even more so during the pandemic. It takes me back to my roots here in the Mission at CellSpace, which is probably one of the best practice spots in the Bay Area. Unfortunately, due to just the changing times with the city, eventually was shut down and converted into luxury condos, which is kind of the MO right now in San Francisco, where a lot of lots have been torn down and basically turned into like luxury condos. CellSpace basically was kind of like just the hub. It brought people from Sacramento, Oakland, East Bay, San Jose, and then obviously San Francisco, like locals alike. And I don't think we'll ever have a spot like that, you know, again. And it's really one of those things that makes you think about San Francisco. So we have the Fisherman's Wharf, we have the Mission, we have Chinatown. CellSpace is one of those spots too that was like its own little like microcosm on its own. The cool thing about CellSpace too was like it gave birth to a lot of programs like that involved community, primarily like youth. So, and yeah, great years, and a lot of dope events were held there. Local rent relief programs that were able to kind of help me, those funds were given to my landlord, who denied that she even got those funds to begin with. So I've been since struggling with affording the rent in my apartment. I've gone to the rent board several times. I filed at least 6 petitions, unlawful rent increases, everything that the rent board says that they're here to defend, wasn't really happening for me. This journey of like trying to just live in my own city. I've reached out to the mayor several times, her constituents, other elected officials that are running for things currently right now. And like many SF tenants, I'm frustrated because it's a lot of empty promises, a lot of waving hands of we're here for our SF tenants, but nothing is happening. We still have people that are struggling with rent. We need these rent protections to be extended even longer so that people can actually get this money and these landlords can actually work with tenants as opposed to just kicking them out on the street during this pandemic. And this is my story.